Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this tutorial we'll write a Python program to print cube and cube root of a given number. If I want to find cube of a number, then I need to multiply that number thrice. For example, if I want to find the cube of 2, then I need to multiply 2 thrice. So I'll get 8. 8 is the cube of 2. If I want cube of 3, then 3 multiply 3 multiply 3, that is 27. 27 is the cube of 3. I can write it as, if I want to find out the cube of x, then I need to multiply x thrice, that is equal to x cube. So you can write the cube of number as power 3 of that number. Here I can write it as 2 power 3, here 3 power 3, in general x power 3. Okay, so this is about the cube of a number. Now what is cube root? Cube root is a special value. When we'll cube that special value, we'll get the original value. That is, if I take 2 power 3, if I cube 2, then I'll get 8, right? Now if I find out the cube root of 8, then I'll get 2. Cube root is represented like this. This is equal to 2. Cube root of 8 is a special value when it is cubed. That is, when I multiply that value thrice, I'll get the original value. Here, cube root of 8 is 2. When I multiply 2 thrice, I'll get the original value 8. If I take cube root of 27, that is 3. The cube root of 27 is 3, because when 3 is cubed, you get 27, right? Now, if I want to write it general, cube root of x is equal to, can write it as x power 1 by 3. We'll write cube of a value as x cube, right? If I want cube root, I can write it as 1 by 3. Alright, now we know what is cube and what is cube root. Cube of x is x cube and cube root of x is, I can write it like this also. Now here I need to write the Python program to print the cube and cube root of the given number. First, let's see how to write the Python program to find the cube of given number. For example, if number is 2, then I can write it as 2 power 3, right? So here power operator is this. So I'll get this. If I use 3, I'll get 27. You can use this power operator, or you can use a function POW, that is power, and here you need to mention the number which you want to cube, and here you need to mention 3. It will give 8. You can find the cube of a negative number also. For example, if I want to find the cube of minus 3, that is minus 3 multiply minus 3 multiply minus 3, so minus 27. So if I do this, minus 3 power 3, I'll get minus 27. I use power, and here you can see the output. Okay, so this is to find the cube of the given number. So let's write the program using function. So here first I'll define a function. I'll take cube, and here I'll take x as the parameter. Here r is equal to, you can do x multiply x also, or you can use this operator and you can find like this also, x power 3, or you can write it as x multiply x multiply x. Then return res. Then here take input from the user. You can take int input or you can take float input too. Now I'll call this function cube, and this function is returning value, so I'll print cube. And here, let's take the value as n. Okay, so we are done. So let's save and execute. Enter the number. I'll enter the number as 6. And 6 cube is 216. I can take negative value 2. If I take minus 5, minus 125. If you want float numbers, you can take here float. And here you need to write the float numbers. For example, 2.1. It is 9.26 something. Alright, so this is about how we can find the cube of given number. Next, let's see how to find the cube root of given number. To find the cube root of given number, I need to take power as 1 by 3. Okay, here I need to change it to 1 by 3. 1 divided by 3. Cube is x power 3. To find the cube root, x power 1 by 3. Right, now let me take int first. Let's execute this. Let's write 27. It is the cube root of 3. When I multiply 3 thrice, I'll get 27. And if I take a negative number, for example, minus 125. So I'm not getting the proper answer here, right? I need to get minus 5, but here I'm getting some different value. So at that time, what we need to do is here. First, you need to take only the positive value, that is 125. You need to find the cube root of that. Later, you can multiply minus 1 to that. So we'll get minus 5. So here in this function, first I need to check if x is less than 0. If x is less than 0 means we are dealing with the negative numbers. Here I need to take x is equal to, I need to find the absolute value without any sign. Okay, we don't want negative value. Later, we need to find result, that is we need to find the cube root of 125 now, not minus 125, 125. We'll take x power 1 by 3. Later, just multiply minus 1 to this. What we are doing is when I enter minus 125, here we are finding the absolute value of minus 125. So I'll get 125 as x. Then we'll find the cube root of 125. Then we'll multiply minus 1 to that. So next here, return result. Right, so now let's see whether it works properly or not. I'll take minus 125. Here you can see. If I take cube root of 81, it is 4.32 something. 164, 0. Okay, so in this way, you can find the cube root. Alright, to find the cube, you need to find the given number power 3. If you want cube root, then you need to find the given number power 1 by 3. Right? Okay, so this is about this program. And here, I'm not using else for values which are equal to or greater than x, because here we used return. After executing return, control will directly come back to here. Okay, so no need to use else here. Alright, so this is about this program. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.